Hello children, I welcome you all to our English class of class 8. Today we'll discuss about our unit 3, reading C, The Garden Within, a poem, and we'll discuss some vocabulary and grammar given in this unit. So let's know about them. Let's know about the poem, The Garden Within by Celia Birrell. Celia Birrell is an England-born Australian writer and poet. She is known for her series of science rhymes, which have been published by CSIRO. CSIRO is Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization, which is an independent Australian federal government agency responsible for scientific research. And she used to write science rhymes, and these were published by the CSIRO. And this poem is also one of it from her series. Okay, children? So let's know about the poem in detail. When you talk about this title, The Garden Within, why did the author choose this title? And let's know in detail, what is the meaning of having a garden within ourselves? How did the author actually try to represent this garden? And how did she explain of having this garden within yourself? Let's get to the details. The poet says that there is a garden in everyone's heart, okay? And when it grows the beauty of yourself, and that shows in the people around you. The smiles are compared to the petals of the flowers, and they are returned back to the owner with a pure heart. Okay, children, when you have a garden within you, so how beautiful the garden will be, similarly, your thoughts will be in your own heart. And your smiles are, of course, compared to the beautiful, colorful petals of the flowers. When you smile at someone, of course, you get it back. And the hope of a better future or inspiration is always to be nurtured in your thoughts. Whatever the beautiful or positive thoughts that you carry in your mind, that should always be taken care. And when you share them with the people around you, like they all feel and enjoy happy about your company, and they get back to you for any kind of inspiration that they need. When these nutritious or the positive thoughts that you are spreading around, they actually feed the spirit of the people around you and give them good inspiration. And people, after receiving this inspiration, positive thoughts, that is actually feeding their spirit, that is feeding their soul with a lot of support. They have that kind of gratitude, okay? So gratitude is nothing but the thankfulness. When they receive a good positive thought from someone, they will certainly have this gratitude. And that gratitude will certainly will make someone very confident to reach their goal. So when people are down with some sadness or something that went wrong in their life, they always need some support. When this positive people are reacting in a good way, spreading their positive thoughts and filling the minds of the people with positivity around them, so certainly it will even help the people who are in despair. They can even boost up their confidence and achieve the goals. And certainly they will have this gratitude of getting help, and they get a lot of soothing, right, to the soul. And of course, the soul receives a lot of support and happiness. So here, children, we have to understand the garden within is the positive thoughts or the positive ideas that are nurtured within yourself. And how you have the thoughts in your mind is always understood by the people around you, who are around you, and the people, the company, which will be around you will also receive the same amount of positive energy. So have a good garden of positive thoughts within you, and please share those positive thoughts of seeds between the people that you come across in your life. Okay, understand this beautiful concept that is very minutely dealt by the author, the garden within. Okay, let's know about the vocabulary and grammar discussed in this unit. Phrasal verbs and figures of speech. Let's know about phrasal verbs given under vocabulary. A phrasal verb is a combination of two or three words, such as a main verb and an adverb, or it can be a main verb and preposition, or it can even be a main verb and adverb and preposition. The combinations can be either ways. Children, don't get confused. You can better understand them when you learn some examples. Children, you also have to remember that phrasal verb should not be understood by the meaning of individual verbs. You already know that it is a combination of words, right? So try to understand them better when the meaning is different, when you are using like a combination, and don't go by the meaning of individual verbs. So try to understand the clear meaning of the phrasal verb, and then you can use them properly when you're writing or speaking. The first example is take up. Take up means to begin a new hobby. It can be used in the sentence like, I'm not very good at basketball. I only took it up recently. So here, took it up, took up is the past form of the take up phrasal verb. Okay. So here it is like a separable phrasal verb and we have a word it in between. So if the words are coming in between, the meaning will not change. Don't worry. But try to understand the meaning of take up. It's actually learning a new hobby. So here, the basketball that is played by someone, it's only a new hobby that is being opted. And so that is why not very good at basketball, because it's learned recently. That is what the sentence means, okay? So the next example, get around. Get around means to travel to different places. I will get around from town to town. So it's like a traveling habit, right? So get around is to travel different places. Try to use this in your discussions. Go along. Go along, what is the meaning of this phrasal verb? That is to continue to happen or to develop. Okay, so he is under the training and is going on well. So some training is being given. Maybe it can be taken along with your academics. The academics are going on well. Go along well. They go along well. Okay, so it is what the same it is. So the next one is come across. Come across is discover something unexpectedly. I came across a card I had never seen before. So you came across something that you had not seen before. So understand the meaning of phrasal verb came across. Breakdown. Children, you can see I have used breakdown twice here. So it means that this phrasal verb has two different meanings in two different situations. Let's know about them. Breakdown, to stop functioning. Our car broke down at the side of the highway. So here, breakdown is used in the sense of stop functioning. So the car broke down. Broke down is past form of the phrasal verb breakdown. So the car stopped working and they had to stop it at the sideway of the highway. Okay. So the next situation is breakdown is to get upset. The woman broke down when the police told her husband had met with an accident. Okay. So that made her to feel very upset. Maybe she was very much worried. Okay, so this is another way of usage of breakdown. There are a lot of phrasal verbs, children. You can try to use them and know them. There are many given under your phrasal verb section in your textbooks. Even try to use them and have a better idea of using them. Let us know about figures of speech given under grammar section. There are a lot of figures of speech which are used in the way of expression of thoughts verbally or in writing. They are like simile, metaphor, personification, alliteration, onomatopoeia, hyperbole or idioms. Let's discuss first what is figures of speech. Figure of speech is use of word that diverges from normal meaning or a phrase with a specialized meaning, not based on the literal meaning of the word, such as metaphor, simile or personification. Figures of speech often provide emphasis, freshness of expression or clarity. So children, you have to understand that in order to make you understand of some concept, these figures of speech try to diverge a little. They give a specialized meaning. Okay, they compare. Sometimes they talk in a sarcastic way, but they try to help you understand the concept much in a better way. So here in this lesson, we'll try to know about simile, metaphor and personification. So in short, figure of speech is an expression of language by which the usual or literal meaning of word is not employed. So you have to understand there is a lot of meaning when we are trying to use a figure of speech. Let's know about the figures of speech in detail. First, let us know the concept of simile. I included some pictures in this so that it will help you the better understanding of the concept as well as keep you interested in this. So let's know about simile. What is a simile? Similes are generally used to compare something with something else, and this comparison is done using the words as or like. So we use these words as or like when we are doing this comparison. As sweet as honey or road like a lion. We have some examples like as tall as giraffe. There are some more phrases here. Let's look at them, children. Wise as a noun, solid as a rock, howls like the wind, quick as a wink, cry like a baby, swim like a fish, quiet like a mouse, grow like a weed, cool as a cucumber. So try to understand, here we are trying to maintain a similarity by comparing the qualities, or we are comparing the attributes and we are trying to maintain a similarity. So that is what is being described using simile. Let's discuss about some more similes. Busy as a bee. The concept of being busy is compared here. Sparkle like diamonds. Hungry as a bear, flat as pancake, hard as rock. One more example. We are two peas in a pod. We are like happy like two peas in a pod. Okay, so when two friends are very comfortable with each other, they are happy. You can use the description of this phrase there. We are like two peas in a pod. Here are some more similes that will help you the better understanding of the concept. Today I'm feeling as fresh as daisy. John runs as fast as lightning. My best friend is as stubborn as mule. After that meal, I feel as fat as a pig. My little sister works as slow as a turtle. Without my glasses, I am as blind as a bat. That boy in my class is as funny as a clown. Right now, I am feeling as sick as a dog. Have you ever felt happy? As happy as hippo? So here, try to understand the quality or the attribute that is being used to compare two different things, and they are maintaining some sort of similarity in their comparison. So learn the similes and try to use them in your verbal speech or even in your writings. Now let's discuss about metaphor. What are metaphors? Metaphors are used to compare two unlike things, but here we are trying to maintain some similarities by comparing some type of qualities. Here we have an example. Kelly has a heart of gold. Can ever heart be gold heart? No. But we are telling like how precious the metal gold is. Similarly, her heart is also so precious. In the next example, we'll try to see like metaphors compare two things by saying that something else is something else. Usually these words are being compared using the words like is, are, was, or were. Okay, my life is like a movie. Life is being compared to movie using the word is. So life can never be movie, but we are trying to maintain some similarity, like the ups and downs or the hard feelings or the happiness that comes and goes in a movie. My life is also happening similarly. You're trying to maintain some similarity. Okay, so let's go to the next example. They are clowns in maths class. So they are being compared to clowns using the word are. So here you have to understand the behavior, how they are doing or behaving in the class. So these people are behaving like that in maths class and hence compared with the clowns. So next example, he has the heart of a lion. So you can say this metaphor when we are using to the person who is very brave. Okay, the meal was a rainbow of flavors. So you can say that meal, whatever you just had all types of flavors. You enjoyed it to the best. So you can use this phrase over there. You are the sunshine of my life. So when you are describing some people who are very important in your life, you can use this metaphor. And understand that we are using the words is, are, was, or were here. Okay. Here are some more metaphors for your better understanding. The sun was a gleaming pearl. So you can understand it was like shining like a pearl in a great way. So the sun is compared to a pearl here. Okay. Can a sun be a pearl? No, but we are comparing two unequal things, but we are trying to maintain some similarity in the comparison. Okay. We are trying to attribute something to something else and trying to maintain a similarity there. My baby brother is a cute little teddy bear. So you say this like your brother is so cute and your teddy bear is also so cute. You are trying to compare your brother with a teddy bear. My sister's memory is a camera that remembers everything we see. So she has a photographic memory, right? So her memory is so powerful and she is remembering each and everything like a picture being taken. So you're comparing the memory of your sister with the camera's memory. Okay. So here the next example, the car seat is a fluffy cloud. So when you are sitting on that, you're feeling like you're sitting on a cloud. Okay. So you're trying to compare two unequal things and trying to maintain a similarity. Okay. The last example is, custard is happiness in a bowl. So you can describe the happiness in a bowl, for suppose it is there in a bowl, it truly means custard to you. So you're trying to explain the happiness in terms of custard that you are about to eat. So learn this concepts of usage of metaphors and that will surely add beauty to your speech. Now let's understand what is personification. Personification is always giving human qualities to animals or objects. So you are describing the lifeless things feelings. Okay, so the feelings of the lifeless things when you are describing using the human qualities, that is what is personification. The stars winked at me. Can ever a star wink at you? Just think. But you're giving a star a human attribute, a human quality. It appears like a star is winking at you. Okay. So the next example, the moon was resting in the midnight sky. Maybe it's like sleeping in the midnight sky. You can see. Can ever a moon take a rest? No. But you're trying to give a human attribute, human quality to the moon. Okay, here again, the next example, the sun played a peekaboo with the clouds. So he's hiding and coming again, he's hiding and coming out. So it's like a peekaboo game. Okay, so you're giving this quality of playing to the sun there. Okay, so here, every morning at 7 a.m. my alarm clock comes alive. So it's coming alive means it is waking you up, right? It is taking a human quality of waking you up. Another example, the wind whistled throughout the day. Can ever a wind whistle? But you are giving it a human attribute that it is sounding like a whistle. So the next example, the leaves dance their way through the lawn. So when you are seeing this, the leaves, when they are moving with the wind, you describe it like the leaves are dancing through the way. Okay. So another example, let's discuss the flame of candle danced in the dark. So you can describe it. It's your own thoughts, children. It's your own way of expression or the beauty that you are seeing in the description. Whatever you see, you can add some beauty by the way you describe it. So personification is always an interesting topic. You can actually give some human qualities to the description and it will actually make the speech or whatever that is written very interesting. Here are some more examples of personification. Let's read them. The sun peeked happily from behind the cloud. So the sun is peeking. Can a sun peek? You're giving a human quality. Understand them. The trees danced back and forth in the wind. Okay. Next example. The car happily squealed down the highway. So it was like enjoying the ride. Even the car is enjoying. It was the time to go home, but the bell refused to ring. So you're feeling bored. You want to go home. But still the bell is not ringing. So you might think that the bell is not feeling to ring. It's time to go home. Okay. Next one. The warm fireplace seemed to be calling my name. Maybe you're feeling too cold and you want to go there. And you feel that the warm fireplace is calling you there. Okay. So you're describing it in that way. The angry sky roared and threw the lightning around. So the sky is very angry and it is throwing the lightning. So you're giving human qualities like being angry or throwing something to the sky and the lightning. Okay. The gentle wind softly kissed my cheeks as I walked. Can a wind generally kiss? But you're giving a human attribute. When the wind is touching, that you're feeling like the wind is kissing the cheeks. Yes. The next one. The delicious smell of cookies pulled me to the kitchen. The smell is now behaving like a person and it is pulling you into the kitchen. Okay. So the next one, the chocolate ice cream cone is really tempting me. So it's like dancing and it's calling you towards it. Okay. So it's like a personification. It's a human attribute thing of attracting you or tempting you is being given to the ice cream cone. Okay, the last one, I can see that news travel quickly. Okay, so the news are a random things of discussion or something that is lifeless, but it's only carried by us, we people talk and spread it. But here you are giving that human quality to the news. So you say that it actually travels quickly, it is moving very quickly. Children, I guess by discussion of these examples, you understood the way of usage of personification. Try to know more and more examples and try to understand them better and use them in your daily usage. Okay? Children, I hope you all understood and enjoyed this class. And I would like to give a small suggestion and that too in this way. So this can be done through figures of speech that we learned today. Life is like riding a bicycle. To keep up your balance, you must keep moving. Okay? So here we are using figures of speech. Try to understand what figures of speech are used in this. And try to learn more and more figures of speech and use them in your day-to-day conversations. Thank you all for listening to the class. Happy learning and meet you in the next class.